Hey everybody, welcome to the first video in my DOS 6.22 tutorial series. While this is the first video, this isn't the first lesson. This is just the steps required to install DOS 6.22 on a virtual machine under Windows, OS 10, or Linux. Once that is done, you'll be able to follow along with me on the actual lessons if you want. But hey, if you just wanted instructions to install a DOS 6.22 virtual machine, that's fine also. Anyhow, let's get started. The first thing you'll need is to download Oracle VirtualBox. Follow the link in the description box. Click the Download VirtualBox button, select the platform package, in my case I'm picking the Windows version, save this file and we'll run it later. The next step is to download the DOS 6.22 image files. These are the disk images of the original installation floppy disks. There is another website with a tutorial that offered these files on a Dropbox share. Since these disk images are in a format that VirtualBox understands, these files are ready to go as is. However, I believe that DOS 6.22 is available from Microsoft for free if you're part of Microsoft TechNet, so you can get these files from them if you want. But you'll still have to convert whatever files they give you to the .img file format that VirtualBox understands. At any rate, these shared Dropbox images save a few steps. Just download them all and put them in a folder. The third step is to install Oracle VirtualBox. Find where you downloaded the installation file, then run it. I pretty much left all the defaults and launched the application. Now we have to create a virtual machine. Click the new icon on the top left. Give your new virtual machine a name and change the version to DOS if it didn't already. Select the amount of memory for the virtual machine. Remember, DOS 6.22 can only access 64 megs of RAM, so no point in setting it any higher. Next, select the size of the hard drive. Again, DOS 6.22 can only support a maximum partition size of 2 gigs. I would create a fixed size hard drive as opposed to one that is dynamically allocated, but that's up to you. I named my virtual hard drive and set the size to 1 gig, which would be plenty for anything I would want to do with it. Once it creates the hard drive, select your new virtual machine from the list on the left and click the green arrow labeled Start. Since the hard drive isn't formatted yet, you'll get this error, no problem. Right-click the floppy disk icon in the bottom row and select Choose Disk Image. From here, search for the floppy image called Setup Disk 1 and click Open. Go to Machine, then Reset to reboot the virtual machine and have it boot from the floppy disk image. The DOS 6.22 setup screen will load. In this step, we'll be formatting the hard drive and doing a full install of DOS 6.22. Press Enter. On the next screen, make sure Configure Unallocated Disk Space is selected and press Enter again. Setup will then format the virtual hard drive and continue. Make sure the system settings are correct and press Enter. You'll be prompted where you want the MS-DOS files. I recommend C:\DOS. Press Enter. The setup program will then copy DOS files to the hard drive. When prompted for a disk change, right-click the floppy disk icon at the bottom and select the image file. It will prompt you for disk 2 and then disk 3. When it's done, you'll see the Remove Disks message. Right-click on the floppy and select Remove Disk from Virtual Drive. Press Enter twice and the virtual machine will reboot with DOS 6.22 from the hard drive. You should get the familiar C prompt. Anyhow, if you got here, good job. You're now ready to start the actual DOS tutorial lessons. That's all I have this week. If you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.